My. Scribe of God, today is a good day. today is a great day in the Lord Jesus Christ, Scribe of God. And we have much to say into the ears of the people in the land today, Scribe of God. Most precious Jesus. Ooh, that is what some say in your land, Scribe of God. they call him most precious Jesus. Oh, they say sweet Holy Spirit. Oh, have you ever heard, Scribe of God, the melodies that come from mankind when they have fallen so deep in love with Jesus? The melodies that come from them, child, it is so sweet. And it is so different. They say sweet Holy Spirit, child. You should hear them in the difference. Oh, sanctuaries. They have their hands lifted so high. Child, remember that you told them that when they lift up their hands in gratitude unto the Lord Jesus Christ, that there is a perfume that proceeds out of the tips of their fingers, and it goes up into the nostrils of the great and mighty God as a sweet smelling savor. I recall you telling the people that, Scribe of God, that is something that they need to always bear in mind, you see. Because you want to be sure that you are doing the right thing, you see, to woo, hallelujah, shende, the Holy Spirit. Oh, I speak to you this morning as one of the many witnesses that bear these things in the kingdom of God, child. I will send it as written in your letters that there is a cloud of witnesses that are in the kingdom. Child, we are from many, many days ago, child. and we abide here in the kingdom of God. And today, Scribe of God, I have been assigned to speak into your ears as a witness. Who am I? Let's speak it into your ears today. Hamashoka, I am a witness. I am one from the many witnesses, you say, that there is a cloud of witnesses that are bold in the kingdom of God. Well, child, I am one of those witnesses, and I am excited to be able to speak into the ears of a scribe, and a female scribe at that. Oh my, child, do you not know that it not has been before that there has been a female scribe? No, child, my breath was taking away when God Almighty did this new thing. Well, I welcome you, female scribe, Abashende. Well, my name, well, female scribe, my name is Felix Scribe. Allow me to introduce myself to you and the hearers, because I understand God Almighty told me on the side, you see. He informed me that when we speak to you, scribe, that there will always be an audience, he says. Well, I am very used to audiences, child, so I have no problem speaking into the ears of an audience. Well, greetings. My name is Felix. Halalo Shende. I abide in the kingdom of God, and I speak into the ears of you, audience, and let us not forget the ears of the female scribe. Scribe of God, you are a small one. You're just so small. You're not like those of days of old, child. Do you not know that there were giants back in those days, child? You no longer see giants walking around these days. But those times are past. Child, the people back then were giants. And the food that was in the land. Did you not read in the letters when the people went over to spy out the land that they carried back grapes and it had to be draped on a stick? Two men had to carry the grapes. One batch. It was a batch. Just one. A batch of grapes. And it took two men. They had to tie it to a stick, child, to bring it back over as proof. And that's when he told the people that the land flowed with milk and honey. Did you read that, child? Oh. But that's not so in your land. I don't want it to appear as if I'm gossiping or anything like that. I'm just sharing, you know, the information. I am a witness, you know. I did see these things. You are such a puny one. It's okay. I mean, I'm not complaining about your size, scribe of God. It's just that, you know, we are familiar with seeing that of the atoms creation and of stature and built, and to see the nurturing Eve, and you're a scribe. I'm not questioning it, scribe of God. Oh no. See, we do not question things in the kingdom of God. No. Once God Almighty says a thing, it is forever. I've heard of you. Do you know that your name is always mentioned in the kingdom? Yes. We are moving about, you know, we're doing our normal things, you know, preparing for the bride and just making sure that all things are in order, and the Buzz, in the kingdom is Tina, the scribe of God. I hear that you have a great assignment coming up. You know, child, we have had others to have the assignment to go into the pit. Yes, these things must be carefully planned out. Now, I understand that Father does give some a glimpse. It is an unscheduled glimpse. they're called revelations. And, just to give them, let them see what heaven is, what hell is. And it's to encourage them, scribe of God, to get on a straight path and be a witness, tell someone else that these things are real, because we have noticed that mankind does not just simply receive words alone. They always need to see something. you people, is there something wrong with your belief system? We have noticed that nor do you believe the words that come from the mouth of your president, past and present. You don't believe. We hear you murmuring all the way up in the kingdom, but we are very busy, but we do hear it. Wow, it is such a pleasure to be with you, scribe of God. Again, my name is Felix. And it is my pleasure to be speaking with you today. And I understand again that we have an audience. Greetings, audience. I am Felix. I am one from the kingdom of God. I am of the witnesses. No, I'm not an angel. No, I am not an angel. I am a witness. I have no powers and or authority. So why do you ask such silly questions? I said that I am a witness. Scribe, what do witnesses do here in your land? Well, a witness just someone who saw something. Well, in my opinion, that is. A witness is someone who saw something, and you're forever a witness because you saw a thing and you can recall it if you should ever need to bring it back up. That's all I got. That's pretty accurate. Scribe. So, yeah, I don't have any powers or anything. What I do have is the most excellent life because I abide in the kingdom of God. So, hallelujah. How is everyone today? How is everyone today? My name is Felix. I am a witness. Abashanda, I abide in the kingdom of God. And my purpose here today is to simply speak with the female scribe. And I am to share some things with you all as well. But I love to talk. Have you ever met someone who is long-winded? Well, you've met your match. I simply enjoy talking. So, scribe, God Almighty does have some words for you and for the listeners. I am so excited to be. I don't know which way to look. I'm looking at the scribe. I'm looking at you all. Oh, this is most excellent. Well, hallelujah. Okay, give me a moment so I can, as you say, gather my thoughts. I'm very excited. Hello, little children. Hello, little children. I speak to the young teenagers. I know that there are teenagers in the audience. Oh, my goodness. Look at you. You may not understand what I'm saying, right? See, we here in the kingdom of God, we can see things as God Almighty allows us to see. You know, it is God Almighty who is all-seeing and all-knowing. And it's not like we're walking around blind or anything. We can see, but it is God Almighty who actually opens up things for us to see. And we always see the children that are walking around, children, those who are in the cribs all the way up to their like 30s, okay? But I see here that we have even younger, we have little adults and teenagers. 12, are you 10 years old? Wow. Oh, this is beautiful. You are beautiful. Wow, children. You know, it is. This is what the time, children, when you should truly take heed to the words that come from the mouth of God Almighty. He has great things in store for you, you know. And he has given you parents, hallelujah, hopefully after his own heart, see. Because we here in the kingdom of God, we understand that sometimes the parents stray, but it should not damage you all, your little children. You're so precious. I cannot recall being so young. Ages 9, 10, 11, 15 years old. Wow, this is such a wonderful time for you. Most wonderful. I pray in the name. I desire to pray a special prayer. Hallelujah. God Almighty. In the precious name of Jesus, I pray now for these young children. God Almighty. Little Boshende, God Almighty, speak long life into them. Handa Kunda, Sinde, long life and respect to your parents, huh? Long life and respect unto your parents. Little children, you must understand that you must obey your parents, because there are many blessings attached to obeying your parents. Did you know that long life comes from obeying your parents? Isn't that awesome? A simple thing as loving and obeying your parents and you get long life. What a deal, right? Oh, I am so in the scribe of God. I'll be with you in a minute. This is so excellent to speak unto the children. My. Oh, and you are of every skin color. You are so beautiful. My. Yes, my name is Felix. Hallelujah. How are you? Yes, I abide in the kingdom of God. I am a witness. I am always in the kingdom of God, always present. Yes. No, I speak to you now from the kingdom of heaven. I am not with the scribe of God. No, I'm not. But God Almighty allows all things to happen as need be. Yes, the kingdom of God is very far away from here. But the earth is the Lord's. Have you ever heard that said in your letters? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Yes. So we are allowed, when permitted, to speak into the ears of whomever God Almighty sends us to. I prefer talking to children. Scribe, I'll be with you in a minute. I'm just so attracted to the children. They're so beautiful, and there's so much possibility in them. Do allow me to speak into the ears of the children. They are so precious. Do you know that Jesus loves you? Do you know that? Melody, is that your name? Melanie? Oh, wow, you are so beautiful. Ashonda babakonda mesinde. God, so you have the most beautiful blue eyes. Do you know that it is Jesus who gave you those beautiful blue eyes, Melanie? Oh, my. Hallelujah. Ah, Konda Mohaya, most precious. Children are most precious in the kingdom of God. Yes. Yes, there are children in the kingdom of God. Well, I cannot tell you exactly how they got there, but I'm glad to tell you that they are there and they are happy. In the kingdom of God, there is no pain. There is no suffering. I can't wait for you to see the flowers there. You know, they're so beautiful, you don't want to pick them. You know, you're not supposed to pick them. But they're so beautiful. All you can do is lay on them. You know, they're so beautiful. They stand just the right height for children. You know, they won't stand over you. Not the flowers. No, they are just the right height. And when you reach down to touch them, you feel the glory of God. They are beautiful. Do they brown? Oh no, they never brown, child. You mean as to die? No. The flowers in the kingdom of God never die. For it is God Almighty who is the air we breathe. He is our life. Nothing dies. There are flowers of every color. You may see a brown flower, but it is not brown due to death or deterioration. No, child. Everything is alive. Children. It is such a delight to see you. Children, do know that the kingdom of God awaits you, but you must obey your parents. And those of you who are older, your teenagers, you must begin to do the right thing, because the word of God is consistent. It does not change. Every one of you will be judged by the same word. There is no special place for children, you see. And I don't want to frighten you. That is not my purpose. But if one does not tell you the truth, how will you know to do a better thing? You must understand that the kingdom of God sees and they hear all things. And unfortunately, some of you do very wicked things when you are out of the presence of your parents. And some of you simply do not obey your parents. Sons of fathers, you must obey your father. I understand that there are times that he provokes you to anger. But it is also written in the letters unto the fathers not to provoke you. I know it is hard for you to do one thing when they do another. It is sad, I know. But children, sons of fathers, you must stand your ground. You are the seed of the house, did you not know? You bear the father's name, your father's name. The seed of your father lies within you. And within you lies your seed and your seed's seed. You must protect the family and not allow the sin of the world to entrap you, to cause you to corrupt yourselves. Ah, Bushanda, there is a saying that is in your land, sons of fathers. I'm speaking to the sons, the boys, the little boys, the young men. There is a saying in your land that a child is a blessing from God. That is what they say in your land. But understand this, sons who carry the seed of life within you. It is you who places the seed inside of the female. Life is within you, and you must be very aware of that. A child is the manifestation of an act, you see. There are many things called blessings. Mankind uses that word in such a weak way. They want to call everything a blessing, but some things are just a manifestation of a thing. Do you know that if you plant an apple seed in good ground, you will receive an apple, eventually, an apple tree. Now, the seed itself is just a seed. That is a seed that you have within you, young men. Boys of the land, I'm speaking into the teenagers. The 8-year-olds, you are so beautiful. 10 years, 15, 16-year-old boys, you have a seed in you. When you plant a seed into good ground, hallelujah, it will produce. Understand this. The ground must be good in order for the seed to be born, to produce. But the growth and the production, the manifestation of the seed, the fruit that comes from it, only God Almighty can call it a blessing or not. A fruit that is produced from a seed, it is just the manifestation of the seed that was planted. That is what it is. Call it what it is. If you plant a seed in good ground, it will produce a thing. Young men, when you lie with a female and you plant that seed that you have in you into the female, which may be good ground, and I say may be, because there are some females that cannot produce children. They are barren. That is the word that God Almighty uses. They are barren. They cannot produce. No, child. I cannot begin to explain to you why a female can be barren. But it is so. And the letters speak of one or two. So you see, men, little boys, when you plant your seed inside of a female and it is good ground, it will produce that of its the seed that was planted within. What you planted was a human seed, one of your kind. You see, every fruit and every man, every animal, every plant, they bear a seed within them. That is how reproduction happens. Mankind has lied so much to the people in this land, scribe of God. I do not desire to leave you standing there, scribe, but the children, they have been lied to on the reproduction of children of their own kind. The seed is within you, young man. It is the female that nurtures the child.
And when you plant the seed inside of the female, you produce another person, another human, another being. And do you know that it is at the discretion of God Almighty to breathe into the nostrils of that child? Did you know that? These things are not, I'm going to say, automatic. Just because you planted a seed inside of a female, it doesn't mean that it will breathe, child. God Almighty must always allow breath into the seed. Mankind would never believe that. But you see, when you are at the age that you are, you can be taught these things, and we can give you understanding so that you will know and you will be more careful with the seed that you carry within you. It is you, young man, 10, 15, 25 years old. It is you all. You carry the seed within you. Ah. And the child that comes from the implanting of the seed is the manifestation of the seed. But understand this, young children and scribe, you too must take heed to this, for it may be asked of you, but you must be able to explain these things in truth. Mankind in your land, they lie one to another, and they let not their children know that the child was born out of sin. They dare not tell the children the truth, the young mothers and young fathers that are producing viciously in your land. They are not committed to one another. They are not legally married in your land. They are but fornicators, scribe of God. And the mothers and the fathers that are in your land, they do not correct the children. Therefore, they see not the wrong in the things that they do. And when they come together and there's a manifestation of a child, they want to call the child blessed. They say that it is a blessing to have a child. No. No. No, it is not. It is a blessing to have a child within wedlock. That is when it is a blessing. For there is a presence of the father and the mother. That is when the child is a blessing. For it mends the hearts of the two together. But when you consider the lives of these young children who do not understand, the beauty of their own bodies and the glory that they carry within them and how precious the seed is, and you should not throw your pearls to swines. You have precious seed in you. You should not just spread them in bad ground. You must understand that the act of bringing forth a child into the world without a mother to keep, to take care, or the father to take care, and that being out of wedlock, which is the will of God Almighty, it is fornication. You have what you see before you is the manifestation of your sin. You refuse to see it that way. You cannot tell any of us here in the kingdom of God, and I speak to you as a witness that have seen much. The many children that are born in your land, little children, are from the acts of fornication. They are unplanned, unwanted seeds being reproduced in the land, and that is because you lack understanding of the precious seed that you have within you. You are so precious to us here in the kingdom of God. You young boys, young, strong men, you carry such strength in you. You carry strength in you. You carry life in you. And you do not understand it. What you carry must be protected. And you must understand that when you lie with a female, and she is good ground, that you will possibly produce a seed. When one buries a seed into the ground, it is much responsibility to care for that seed. You plant the seed in good ground and you wait, and you wait, for the seed is deep within the grounds. And the grounds begin to nurture and keep the seed warm as the seed itself toils within the ground. And it's months that pass, but you keep into your little minds that I planted a seed right there. And you keep a watchful eye on that one area where you know you planted that seed. And when you see the first evidence of the blade that sticks from the ground there. Oh, what a joy to see that one green blade break through the ground. That is the evidence of your seed. Planted in good ground and with love and with the desire to take care of it. And though all you see is the little green blade thereof, you become very highly protected of it. You want to put a little fence around it to make sure that everyone is aware. This is my seed. This is my seed. Be careful. This is my seed. Seed is right there. I can see the manifestation of the act of me releasing my seed and putting it in good ground. What it is evidence and the manifestation of the seed that you have planted. That is all that a child is. Whether it is in wedlock, and when I say wedlock, I mean when people are married, when there is a husband and a wife, when there is a male and a female, where there is Adam and Eve, when they come together. And the man plants the seed. Life is in the man. The life is in you, young boys. Life. And when you give your seed away, outside of being married, you are in sin. You are in sin. If you are not married to the female that you plant your seed within, you are in sin, she is in sin, and you will have a manifestation of your sin. Mankind will not say these words to you, but these I speak truth. I see many children born in your land, and they have no mothers, or they have no fathers. O born shede la sarababa. Oh, it is so sad. And the children are not brought up in the ways of the kingdom. It is written in your land, in the letters, to train up a child in the way that they should go. Young children, 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 I speak to the children. It is the desire of God Almighty that you grow up strong. Strong in the knowledge of God. Not just healthy and bodily strength, but strong in the knowledge of God and in the understanding of the kingdom of God, that you may walk up right before Him and be a representation of the kingdom of God. Children, you are most precious to God Almighty. Do you know that He will spend many, many days just sitting and talking with you? Do you know why we here in the kingdom of God talk so much? We copy of God Almighty, of course. But let me tell you, God Almighty would love to just sit and talk with you for hours and hours. The conversations would never end. He knows so much and he is so funny. The imagination and the thoughts of God Almighty can never run out. And he desires to speak with you continuously. Just talk and talk, and you talk back to him, because he wants you to become familiar with the sound of his voice, you see. For he is the good shepherd, and you are the sheep, you see. God Almighty is the good shepherd, and you little ones are the sheep. And even in the natural, the sheep recognizes the shepherd when he enters the gate, because the shepherd has spent so much time with them that they know his scent and they know the tone of his voice, the tone of his voice. So if another should enter the gate, they will not follow that stranger, because they are used to hearing the tone of their master. If you are amongst a group of people, females, if you are amongst a group of females, and your mother was also in the midst of all those females, do you not know that you would identify the voice of your mother over all of those females who were speaking? Because you have been in the presence of your mother for many years, and you know her voice, and a stranger, you will not follow. That is why God Almighty desires to talk so much to you. And if you would simply talk back to him, he will go on and on. The scribe here always talks to God Almighty, and I do not mean, scribe of God, to not speak to you, but my heart has turned to the children. The scribe of God always talks to God Almighty. Actually, she talks to us all. Daily. Almost every minute of the day. And I am of the kingdom of God, so I lie not. Her conversations with us are as if we are actually before her at all times. She is a pleasure to watch. She really is. She almost talks as much as we do. I think we have rubbed off on her. Children, do know that it is the desire of God Almighty, and I am speaking to you young children, so precious to God Almighty. He desires that you desire him.
He wants you to want Him. Would you stay up all night if you were on your phone communications with one that you love? You would probably stay up very long just to continue to hear their voices. You see, you must fall in love with God Almighty that way. He needs to become your purpose, your reason, and your explanation, you see. He must become your reason, your purpose, and your explanation. My name is Felix Chow. My name is said differently in the kingdom of God. But as we speak into the ears of mankind, our language must break through the barriers that you can hear and understand what we are saying. No, child, this, what you hear, is not our language. This is your language. This that you hear is not the language of the kingdom of God. Just as there are many nations here in your land, and they all have a different tongue, well, we too are of a different nation, I will say, and we have our own tongue, but it is at the beauty of God Almighty that these things can be. Were you able to listen on the other day that the scribe of God exercised divers tongues? Oh, it was beautiful. For you see, the scribe of God speaks in your tongue as well. Simply, I believe this is American, an American tongue. She speaks with your tongue. But yesterday was a day of assignment for her, and the scribe of God spoke to six nations in their tongue by the will of the Holy Ghost that abides within her. For within the Holy Ghost abides all things. And when the Holy Ghost abides in you, therefore all things abide in you, and you are without limits. And it was the desire of God Almighty on that assigned day to speak into the ears of many nations, children. Because you see, there are people all over the world, you see, there are people in nations and who live in on lands that speak not of a language that you have ever heard, but within the Holy Ghost lies the ability to speak all languages. It is written in your letters, little children. When you read, it speaks of diverse tongues. Diverse mean many, different, variety, you see. And all of these abilities lie within the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of the living God, the Holy Spirit. It lies within Him. And inside of the scribe of God is where the Holy Spirit lies. He abides in her also. Therefore, we were able to use her liberally to speak into different nations that they may know that the time of the returning of the Lord Jesus Christ is upon their land, and that there is no more time, and that they must prepare themselves for the troubles and the woes that are coming upon the land. There are many gifts and manifestations inside of the Holy Ghost, and they manifest through the female scribe. She, little children, will be great in your land. And this is not to place her above anyone, child, but she has become a willing vessel. And that is the desires that we have for you too, little children, that you become a willing vessel, that God Almighty can use you mightily, can speak into your ears and lead you and guide you. It was a beautiful manifestation yesterday to hear the different nations be spoken to through the female scribe. You too can have that to manifest through you, little children. There is no age limit to the receiving of the Holy Ghost. He is present in your land. He is present wherever you go. You do not seek Him. He's already present. You just have to desire Him. Just as you desire the affections of a female, or you desire the affections of a male, you must begin to desire Him. And He will manifest Himself in you, and you will hear His language come out of your mouths. It is not trickery. And it is not something that you can practice. Understand this, little children. For I know that your little minds are easily mended and molded. Understand this. And I speak to you as a witness from the kingdom of God. My name is Felix. Little children, do not fall into sin by attempting to manifest your own language out of your mouth. Do not practice a thing that you have heard. You will find yourself being attacked by unclean, unwanted spirits because you do not know what you say. Ikunda, understand the words that are coming out of my mouth, children, for I have become so attracted to you. There are many children in the kingdom of God, and they are most precious. Desire me. Desire as I desire. Desire earnestly. Desire earnestly. The Spirit of the Lord is present.
and the manifestation that you will receive, that he has abode in you, that he has stepped inside of you, that he has become pleased with you, is you will begin to speak the language that we speak here in the kingdom of God. You see, it is an unlearned language. You cannot learn it. It is of another. But when we come together with you and agree, you will begin to speak our language as a manifestation unto you, as proof unto you, as evidence unto you. You may cry when you feel the Holy Ghost become close to you, because he carries a beautiful presence with him. And you may find that you may cry, and you may shake, and you may find out that you can no longer stand up, and you may fall to your knees. That is simply his presence. He is drawing nigh to you. But don't stop there. Do not become shaken. Continue to draw him nigh to you until he steps inside and you become one, and your tongue will begin to sing the praises of the Most High in such a beautiful language. Allo scende le liando lo kunda la malenenisi. You will find freedom in him. Sunda da baba scende le o hunda da baba haya. It will be beautiful, children. But you must allow him to draw close to you. And as he begins to grow close to you, never let him go. Hallelujah. God Almighty enjoys that song. There is one in your land who sings that song. I believe he is the producer of the song. If you should see him, if you should see him, would you tell him for me? If you should see him, he who produced that song, would you tell him that God Almighty is well pleased with his melody, and that he heard his heart when he produced that very melody? It is such a beautiful melody. If you should see him, him for me, that feeling said that God Almighty heard his heart. Oh, from that one melody, children of God, God Almighty, he hears and he sees all things. Even we here in the kingdom of God enjoy that melody. It is such a wooing song. And to woo someone, children, is to draw them close to you in love. To get their attention to where they must begin to come your way because of the melody that comes from you or the eye contact that you are giving them. If you should see the one who made that melody, would you tell him from me that God Almighty enjoys that melody? Draw me close to you, children. You should sing that song. Cause that to be a practice of yours. Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again. Oh, children, bring your cares and your concerns. Bring your tears and your burdens. Your worries to the Lord Jesus Christ. And lay them down again. You should leave them there, children. He is a good God. He will take care of it. Desire to draw closer to Jesus. Draw closer to Jesus. Draw closer to Jesus. Draw closer to Jesus. I grow closer to Jesus. Now is the time. Grow closer. To Jesus. He is the one and only true and living God. Grow closer.
To Jesus. Let every heart and every mouth open and proclaim that Jesus is Lord. Grow closer, hallelujah, to Jesus. Obey your parents, hundredbohunda. Repent from your sins, hallelujah. And draw me closer, hundredmore, said the Holy Spirit. Draw me closer, says the Holy Spirit. He says, draw him close to you, and he will draw close to you, and he will begin to commune with you. And he will begin to speak through you. Hallelujah. For it is his great desire to commune and to fellowship with the children. Let the children begin to declare that Jesus Christ is Lord. Let there be an open declaration that Jesus Christ is Lord. Let all the young people stand for Christ Jesus. Let there be a breakthrough and a breakout. Let the young girls and the young boys begin to declare that Jesus Christ is Lord. That Jesus Christ is Lord. He is the one true and living God. And that they will begin to declare and stand on the word of God. That they will begin to read the letters, hallelujah, that are in their bedrooms, that are in their book sacks, that are in their dresser drawers, that is available to them on their mobile devices, God. Hallelujah, God, let the praise begin. Let the praise begin. Let the praise begin. Hallelujah, for there will be a great revival, huh? And the young people will be part of that great revival, huh? Let them all begin to declare that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is the one true and living God. Let them declare it, let them declare it, let them declare it, let them declare it. Let every hand be lifted up high. You need to understand that when you lift your hands up high and you begin to move your fingers around, that it releases a perfume. Let the perfume begin to be released. Raise your hands unto the Lord Jesus Christ. Let there be a wave offering. Let there be a wave offering. The releasing of perfume. Shende lokunda. Yes, the releasing of perfumes in the air. The releasing of perfumes in the air. Honda rababa sindi oshunda. Rasha kola sendeli oshundaramai. Ye kala shendeli shundarabahaya, children of the land. Wait on the manifestation of the Holy Ghost. Wait on the manifestation of the Holy Ghost. When you begin to feel his presence approaching you, understand this, little children, and I speak to children of all ages. When you begin to feel the presence of the Holy Ghost approaching you, understand this, when you set the atmosphere for your love to come, you should always expect him.
Are you understanding what I am saying to you, young children? If you set yourself in a certain place where you cannot be disturbed, and whether you are sitting in that one place quietly, or you have set that place with a melody, and you are waiting on the presence of the living God to approach you, when you are waiting for the presence of the Holy Ghost to approach you, when you have set up that atmosphere, hallelujah, you are to wait on the presence of the Holy Ghost. And when he begins to approach you, you're going to feel his presence some type of way, because you see he carries a glory with him. Hallelujah. And you will begin to feel that thing, and he can be miles away from you. But he is approaching you, you see. Andohana, he is approaching you. Do not become frightened. It is nothing to frighten you. But because you have not experienced this manifestation of him, it may feel a little different. I, Felix, say to you, remain in your place and take it in. You may cry, you may begin to tremble, you even may feel the unction to get on your knees. He is holy. He is holy. Allow him to approach you. And if you are one who desires to sing to him, then sing to him. But if while you are singing, your tongue begins to feel a little different, continue to sing. For he may take over your tongue, you see, and you may begin to sing a different melody. I would love to be there for that. Children, he can manifest himself in many ways. Desire him. When he approaches you, you may feel a something upon you, or as if something is approaching you. And when you are singing, you may feel like you want to change the melody because you have a certain song in you that you desire to sing. But if he is approaching you, your desires may change and you may not know the melody. It is okay. Sing the melody. Let the romancing begin. Children, let the romancing begin. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is to be praised. Children, you must understand those words and begin to practice that very action. Do you know that the female scribe of God rises 4 a.m. in the morning? Did you know that? It has not always been that way. There has been many interruptions in her life where she had to continue to change the times because she have a strong desire to spend time in the presence of God Almighty. And her times kept changing and changing because things were changing in her life. But she refused to let time dictate to her. They say in the land that when it is night time, one should rest. And one should get up when the sun rises. But the scribe of God is awake before the sun rises, you see. She has prioritized and refused to let time of day dictate to her. She has decided that she will control the time that she spends with God Almighty. She does not have to wait until the sun rises. She does not have to get a set amount of hours to sleep. She refused to let mankind dictate to her and say that she should not get up that early or that she should not go to bed that early. She do what she needs to do in order to be present and readily available for God Almighty. And it has been a practice of hers for many years. And now today, you hear how God Almighty uses her mightily. Why? Because she made herself available. How do you make yourself available? You wait and you sit and you sit and you wait and you wait and you sit and you sit and you wait. It does not matter if God is not talking to you at that time. You are making yourself available. Make yourself available. It does not matter if you have awakened for the past 3 days and God has not said anything to you. Well, thank you for making yourself available. Will you continue to make yourself available until God Almighty has said something unto you? Or will you stop now because you have given him a number of days to do something or you're going to walk away? Make yourself available. When you see different men and women and children of God being used mightily, there was a sacrifice that had to take place before they got in that position. Many sacrifices that you do not know of. Sacrifices that they did not want to sacrifice in the beginning, but as they went through, they found God Almighty worthy. God Almighty, you are worthy of me putting away this and no longer going there and not seeing this and not wearing that and not talking to this one. God Almighty, we find you worthy. Sacrifice. Deny yourself and wait and see how God Almighty will begin to use you mightily, children. And I still speak unto the children. Scribe of God, I did desire to speak with you, scribe, but the children were here. Know and understand this, little children. Jesus Christ desires to hear your voice. He desires to hear your praise. He desires to hear your worship. There is no such thing as you cannot sing. Don't say that. Each one of you can make a melody. Sing. Make a melody. There is no such thing as you cannot sing. No, there is no such thing as you don't know any songs. Don't say that. Don't say you do not know any songs. Make up a melody in your head. Sing of the goodness of Jesus. Make a new melody. And when you sing, sing with understanding. Do not just belt out some worldly song and think that you are wooing Jesus. No. Children, I will keep my eye on you. I love children, scribe of God. I do. They are most precious. And they hold such power and authority within them that they don't know of. Children. Know that God Almighty hears and he sees all things. And let me say this to you, children, because, scribe of God, I hate, and I want everyone to hear this, scribe of God, I hate when your leaders are those unlearned teachers that walk your land decide to say that God will not hear you unless you say the sinner's prayer. Scribe of God, what is a sinner's prayer? Huh? Is there some special words that mankind is supposed to say? I should identify myself as a sinner because somebody please help me out with the sinner's prayer. Scribe, what is that foolishness? Repeat after me. Repeat the sinner's prayer. Where did they get that from, scribe? Is that somewhere written in the letters that I missed? Line up to me, scribe. Is there a sinner's prayer written somewhere in the letters that I miss? Huh? Sinner's prayer. Foolishness. Do you know why mankind can't get a breakthrough? Ignorance. And I'm speaking to you, children, don't leave. I'm just having a word with the scribe about the stoop stupid sinner's prayer, children. There's no sinner's prayer, children. Children, listen to me. There is no sinner's prayer. I guess there is also a saved prayer and a prayer of food and I don't know what other foolishness mankind can think of. Scribe of God, make that known unto the people in the land, scribe, that they are very incorrect with their foolish sinner's prayer. Repeat after me. God, forgive me of my sins. Really? Children. When you ask for forgiveness of your sins, with a sincere, sorrowful, Lord, I want to get my life right with you. I don't want to die and go into the pit kind of way. Simply repent. There is no repeat after me. Everybody stand in the line. Scrap of God, I apologize. I don't mean to. These children, scribe, the ways of mankind, they're so wicked, they're foolish. Why should the people get in the line and repeat after them? And I believe there are some that say, raise your right hand and repeat after me. Or they may say something like, get on your knees. I'm going to anoint you with this oil. And I'm going to cover you up with this piece of cloth. Because you see, you got to be in a merciful position. Scribe. What is that? They put bondages on the people. And now you've got people that's walking around like these dear children over here. And they're saying to themselves, I want to give my life to God, but I don't know the sinner's prayer. Can somebody help me? But they're bound up because they feel now that they need to go look for someone to help them with the sinner's prayer. What is? You know what? You know what, scribe? Oh, well, hold up. I'm not authorized to say what I was about to say, so. Okay, so let's drop that, scribe. You see these children over here, scribe? This is foolishness. To have these children thinking that they cannot repent and that they need someone's assistance, okay, to have them repeat after them with the sinner's prayer. And do you know, even with the stupidity of mankind, even with all your strong leaders and your chief apostles, you know what, scribe of God, I would love to meet a chief apostle. You see, the people in your land, they read the books and they have read about Paul. See? Scribe! There's so much I can say. But you see, the men that walk your land, those who are leadership, that's given themselves golden chairs and golden rings, okay? And the people, they have to bow and they have to applaud
and they have to kiss the ring and honor him. Scribe. I don't know where all that come from. But see, mankind, they need to always make a way. They always need to make some kind of ceremony. They don't even know where those ceremonies come from. Scribe of God, I do not understand mankind. They wear their long robes. What is that, scribe? Okay, let me get back to the children. Scribe, I would like to discuss this with you without the audience. So you can tell me about these chief apostles and chief pastors and chiefs and sergeants and generals and masters and lords that you have in your land. Who told them that they masters and chiefs and... I wish a chief apostle would come to me and say something foolish. Chief apostle. Chief evangelist. Most holy fathers. Scribe, don't get me started. Because I am not like many that are in the kingdom of God, okay? I introduced myself when I came upon. My name is Felix, and I am one of the many witnesses, okay? And we know that at any time, God Almighty can shut my mouth. But he must be well pleased with the words that I'm saying, because you see these leaders that walk your land, that's got these children in bondage, and the fathers that are in the homes, and the mothers that are in the homes are just as ignorant, and they're thinking that, well, baby, I don't know what the sinner's prayer is. We're going to have to talk to such and such. Who is such and such? I would love to speak to such and such so they could explain to me where this sinner's prayer organization piece of crap come from. These children should not be in bondage like this, waiting for someone to tell them a sinner's prayer. You know what a sinner's prayer is? Help me, Jesus. Help me, Lord. God, forgive me. That's screaming out. See, when you scream out, there's your sinner's prayer. But they want to have these children bound up and have a 3-4-page letter that they have to read out loud in public. They didn't read out their sins in public. They put burdens on people that they cannot bear themselves. Oh, but I release these children today. Ah, children. Children. Listen to Felix today. In the name of Jesus, Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, all you need to do is ask and you shall receive. Sincerely, with a made-up mind, find your quiet place and speak to the Lord Jesus, just you and He, and confess your sin unto Him. And let him know how you feel about him. And repent. And if you can recall every sin, then speak that sin and give it up to God. God Almighty, forgive me for stealing that pencil off of her desk, Jesus. Forgive me for stealing. God Almighty, forgive me for pushing her down the stairs. God, forgive me. If you can call out every sin, if you can, then call them out. That's if you can. If you cannot, that is okay. There's nothing wrong with that. The posture of you, the posture being the way, the posture of you, the way that you ought to be before him is humble and sincere. And say that you are sorry and that you repent. And just begin to talk to him. He is listening. Be sincere. Know that your lover is listening. And you know what, children? So is the Holy Ghost. He's listening. He desires so much to abide in you. And as you are repenting, and the tears are falling from your eyes, you just stay there. You just stay there and be broken before God Almighty. Just stay there and be broken. And keep your words unto him. And each day, remind him of how much you love him. And show him how much you love him each day. And you will see that your time will increase more and more that you will spend. You will see it may start off with 5 minutes. And then the next day it may be 8 minutes. And the next day it might be 9 minutes. The next day it may be 15 minutes. And before you know it, you're going to be putting your favorite television show on the side, which is 30 minutes. You're going to be with God for 30 minutes. Do you know how long that is? Oh, so much can happen in 30 minutes. And it's going to continue to increase because you're going to be falling in love with him. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Seek the Holy Ghost while there is yet time standing.